We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Good morning all. Yes, my dear students, welcome to my YouTube channel. Again, we will discuss another topic under the heading of Human Resource Planning and Development. Again, yes, to be continued with module 4. Today we will discuss the fifth topic under the heading of module 4, Global Perspectives on HRD. That is Management Development and Management Education Training. These 2 points that we'll discuss we will discuss about management development, and in the next session we will discuss about management education training. So welcome in my YouTube channel again. Part 1, Management Development. Let's discuss. Topics to be covered under the heading of management development: concept, definition, approaches, holistic view in manager's job, need assessment in management development, components of management development, and last, conclusion, summary. These 4 points we'll discuss in part 1 video, and in the very next video, in the very next session, we will definitely discuss about need assessment in management development, in short why, and second, components of management development. In this session, 3 questions are most important for exam point of view. First, approaches. Second, holistic view in manager's job with reference to management development. And third one, components of management development. These 3 questions most important. It can be asked as 7 marks in your examination. So let's start. Let's discuss about what is all about management development. Management development is a very popular HRD activity. It is a systematic process of growth and development by which the managers develop their abilities to manage. It is concerned with improving performance of the managers by giving them opportunities for growth and development. Management development is a systematic process of training and growth by which managerial personnel gain and apply skill, knowledge, attitude, and insights to manage the work in their organization effectively and efficiently. In other words, it is management's responsibility of ensuring the success of organization. According to Flippo, what is all about management development? So according to Flippo, management development includes the process by which managers and executives acquire not only skills and competencies in their present jobs, but also capacities for future managerial tasks. Yes, important concept for exam point of view. It can be asked as 7 marks in your GTU examination. Approaches to understanding the job of managing, or job of managers, whatever you say. Yes, basically 3 approaches on the heading of the understanding the job of managing. First, describing the characteristics of jobs. Second, describing the roles managers serve. And last one, developing process models. What is all about? In the first approach, you have to describe the features of job, which type of job you want, which type of job you develop, which type of job you want to survive in your organization. Second, it's all about describe the role. What is the basic difference between describing the features as well as describing the role? Describing the features means what? You just have to identify, you just have to clarify what are the features under the heading of this particular job. while under the heading of describing the roles, it means what are the duties, what are the responsibilities that you have to perform while you are working in particular organization. So these are the basic approaches. We'll discuss one by one. Start with first describing the characteristics of jobs. The characteristics approach involves observing the task managers perform and grouping them into meaningful categories. McCall, Morrison and Hanan reviewed the results of a group of observational studies and concluded that 10 elements of managing were consistently present. These elements indicate that the management job involves long hours of work, varied activities, primarily oral communication, many contacts and information gathering. These observations may be interesting. They do not provide much assistance in describing specifically what managers do, how they do it, and how they should be developed. So this is the basic funda behind the describing the characteristics of job. Then you have to identify the job, you have to identify your activity, you have to identify your hours of work. On the basis of that, you just easily describe which type of feature, which type of job you want in your organization. Second, it's all about describing the roles managers serve. Basically, two approach with reference to describing the role. A second approach to describing the managerial job is to identify the role that managers are typically assigned. This can be accomplished by using the following approaches. Two approaches, starting with the first observational approach, and second one is all about the empirical approach. Yes, observational approach. This approach is typified by FAO's five management functions: planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, and controlling. And Ms. Bull's managerial roles: interpersonal and decisional. Interpersonal leads for figurehead, leader, and liaison. Informational leads for monitor, disseminator, and spokesperson. And decisional stands for entrepreneur, disturbance handler, resource allocator, and negotiator. While these categorizations are extremely popular, they too do not adequately describe what managers do. They also lack specificity. So observational approach covers particularly three categories, rather three headings under the heading of five functions. Basically, what are the five functions? Yes, planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, and controlling. These are the five functions. So according to FAO's five management functions and according to Mintzberg's managerial role, we can easily observe the approach with reference to describing the roles of managers. So yes, talking about second approach under the heading of describing the roles managers serve, empirical approach. It relies on a descriptive questionnaire that is completed by managers themselves and or by others who work with them. However, even this approach has failed to provide practical, meaningful descriptions of the job. Taken together, the observational and empirical approaches to categorizing the managerial role have not proved useful as a definition of the managerial job or as a guide to developing managers. So this is the basic approach, basic funda behind describing the roles managing serve. The model is based on the assumptions that certain identifiable competencies are critical for effective leadership. The knowledge, skills, behaviors, personal attributes, and other characteristics that are associated with or predictive of superior job performance. These are the list of specific competencies varies somewhat across research. First, Werner and Desimore proposed that rather than attempting to isolate specific competencies, a better approach would be to identify categories or cluster of competencies since the specific requirements of business often vary. Werner and Desimore provides six competencies. First, HRM. Second, leadership. Third, goal and action management. Fourth, directing subordinates. Fifth, focus on others. And last, specialized knowledge. Yes, starting with the first, what is all about HRM? It covers proper use of power, positive social skills, and accurate self-understanding. Leadership means self-confidence, oral presentation skills, ability to think logically and conceptualize. third, it's all about the goal and action management. It covers proactive, efficient, and ability to diagnostically evaluate outcomes. Outcomes means, yes, results. Next one, directing subordinates means what? The ability effectively use unilateral power, the ability to develop others while coaching orientation. And next, focus on others. Yes, again, important concept, again, important competence according to Werner and Desimore. It's all about the ability effectively use unilateral power. Yes, sorry. Focus on others. It means stamina, self-control, adaptability, and concern for others. And last, most important, specialized knowledge. Knowledge of group goals and related tasks. Requirements. This is the basic six competencies clusters on according to Werner and Desimore. Second process model. So under the heading of third model, basically three approaches. First, describing the characteristics of job. Second, describing the role of the managers have to serve. And third one, process model, developing process model. So under the developing process model, two types of model. First, according to Werner and Desimore, six competency model. And second, model of the managerial job, which helps in designing managerial development, is the four-dimensional model. So according to developing process model, with reference to management development of approaches of management development, basically three approaches: describing the features, describing the role, and developing the model. So under the third approach, developing process model, two models again. First model, according to Werner and Desimore, six competencies. And second, it's all about the four dimensional model. This model has evolved the dimensions of the managerial role based on various information sources provided, such as interview, performance evaluation documents. And the dimensions, four dimensions, are six functions, four roles, five targets, and managerial styles. See, basically four-dimensional model, these are the four-dimensional model. First dimension model is all about the six functions. Then how many functions? Six functions. Which are the functions? What are the functions? Forecasting and planning, training and development, persuasive communication, influence and control, expertise or functional area, and administration. These are the six functions of the first dimensional model. Second dimensional model is all about the four roles. How many? Four roles. What are the four roles? Innovator, evaluator, motivator, and director. Next one, five targets: peers, subordinates, superiors, external means stakeholders, and self. And last, fourth dimensional model, it's all about the managerial styles. Attributes which describe the image and approach of the managers, that is leadership, risk taking, objectivity, personal impact, energy level, etc. So basically, under the heading of developing process model, with reference to third approach of the management development, it covers two process model. First, it's all about the Werner and Desimore's six competency cluster model. And second one, it's all about the four dimension model. Under the heading of Werner and Desimore model, basically cover six functions, six competencies, rather, HRM, leadership, goal and action management, directing subordinates, focus on others, and last, specialized knowledge. While moving towards the second process model, it's all about the four-dimensional model. It covers basically four-dimensional models. First, six functions, four roles, five targets, and last one, managerial styles. Yes, again, important concept for exam point of view. It's all about the holistic view of manager's job. What is all about? Holistic view of manager's job. Mintzberg developed a model of the manager's job, which attempts to bring together what has been learned about the managerial job in a holistic manner. His attempt has been to gather the richness. His model represents the manager's job as framework of concentric circles, which he calls well-rounded job. So you can also called as a well-rounded job with reference to holistic view of manager's job. So in the examination, if the question is like that, explain well-rounded job with reference to management development, then you all are required to write down this concept with reference to holistic view of manager's job. The words in the model represent seven interrelated roles that are seen by Mintzberg as comprising of the managerial job. So under the heading of holistic view, you all are required to write down these seven interrelated roles to cover well-rounded job concept: conceiving, scheduling, communicating, controlling, leading, linking, and doing. Seven interrelated roles. Most important question for exam point of view. And if the question is like that in your examination, explain Mintzberg well-rounded job, then same answer. The question is like that, holistic view of manager's job with reference to Mintzberg well-rounded job, same answer. So there are many questions, but answer only what it's all about, the seven interrelated roles. Most important diagram, most important chart, you all are requested to draw this image. Through this, you can easily identify, through this, you can easily analyze, through this, you can easily explain what is actually and what are the interrelated roles that you have to follow while you are talking about the well-rounded job with reference to Mintzberg's well-rounded job. Yes, just see, basically six: first, conceiving; second, scheduling; third, communicating; fourth, controlling; fifth, leading; sixth, linking; and seventh, doing. Yes, so basically 7 points. You just strike out all the points on the basis of this. You just require to write down one by one role, interrelated role, starting with the first. It's all about the conceiving roles. What is actually it? Yes, so at the center of the model, is the person in the job who brings a set of values, experiences, knowledge, competencies to the job. All these components combine to form a manager's managerial style, which drives him to perform his job effectively. So center of the model, person, conceiving. Second, it's all about the next circle. It's all about the scheduling. So after the person circle, it's all about the scheduling. The next circle contains the agenda of work. The agenda consists of the issues that are of concern to the manager and the schedule of the manager to accomplish his role in them. This work involves the role of scheduling. Mintzberg says, these levels of actions evoked here, managing through information, which involves role of communicating, controlling; managing through people, which involves the roles of linking and leading; and managing three direct actions, which involves the roles of doing or accomplishing the task. So scheduling covers the another five interrelated roles. So with reference to scheduling, you can easily direct your next role with reference to scheduling. So first, starting with the conceiving, main centric role. Second one, on the basis of this conceiving, you just schedule your plan, you just schedule your jobs. Yes, next one, it's all about the communicating. On the basis of the scheduling, you can easily communicate with each other. On the basis of the communication, you are easily control your actions, you can easily control your plan. On the basis of the controlling, you can easily lead your people with other people. You can easily lead, you can easily become a leader. On the basis of the leading competence, you are just required to just link with leading. And last words about the doing. So linking is the main centric area, from the leading to doing. So this is the basic Mintzberg's well-rounded job. This model should be viewed as one of the work in progress, awaiting development and validation of the research model. This model contributes. Managers are after all people. Jobs of managing is complex, manufactured, and integrated. And managers are people who perform certain roles, and they are not merely a collection of certain competencies and KSA. KSA stands for knowledge, skill, and abilities. So this is the basic well-rounded Mintzberg's model of the managerial development, and it was asked in 7 marks, and it can be again asked in 7 marks in your final examination. So please focus on these interrelated jobs, focus on the interrelated roles, and define one by one with reference to Mintzberg's well-rounded job of management development. So here we are keeping up to this. In the next session, we'll discuss need assessment in management development. Yes, see you soon. Thank you.